Welcome to a beginner ride. It's 20 minutes long. There won't be any weights. And it's hip hop. Because I feel like every beginner class that I've seen is like really crappy music. So we got you covered with the good music. Is that an angel I hear? Oh, it's Beyonce. All right, let's add a couple turns. That beautiful knob in between your legs, that dictates your ride. So you start at zero, and then you start to turn up. And you add enough so that you can hold the tempo of the music without slowing down and feeling enough control, right? So your hands can be right in the center bar, and everybody's handle bars are going to be different, but this is essentially first here. Second is here. We're going to take a deep breath in, bring your shoulders up. Exhale out, let it go. So, I'm looking at about 97 RPMs. If you don't have a bike here, that is absolutely fine. The way that I ride is called rhythm riding. So what you're doing is pedaling to the beat of the music. Makes it way more fun. So, your leg is extended on the downbeat. Right now, I don't want you to worry about your lead leg. But if I were to say which leg is the lead leg, for me right now, it would be your left leg, your mirror image of me. Reach down, add a little bit. Now, I can't tell you how much to add. It depends on how you feel. But I will say this. If I ask you to add, the only reason you wouldn't add more is if you know that you would not be able to hold on to the rhythm. Okay, we're not here to be stagnant. We're not here to be complacent, right? Good. So right here, I want you to pick up your pace. Go a little bit faster. You can always use my legs, my feet as a reference. Okay? So it's a little push above the beat. 5 or 10 RPMs, which are equivalent to your BPMs, which is what the music is, right? So you sync up your revolutions to the beat. Make sense? Good, down on the back. Back on the rhythm. 97 to 100. Shoulders down. Add it. Good. So, with any class you take, just know that you take what you need from that class. If there's something that makes you feel silly or awkward, let that shit go. Right? You do what feels best for you. Just don't do basics, okay? Good. Yeah. And you dance, right? It's a celebration of your body. It's a celebration of life, and there's always a reason to dance. Always. Ready? Okay. Right here, we got one more push. A little bit ahead of the beat, and we take it to the end of the song. Push, push, push. Okay. If you're faster than 105 or faster than my legs, add resistance, and that will give you the support that you need. Dial it back. Great job. Okay, so your body should be feeling warm. You might be breathing through your mouth like I am. That's a good thing. Your body's requiring more oxygen. So now, what I'd like to do is help you get a better understanding of what the lead leg situation is, right? So right here, I'm on the right leg lead, right? Right. Just below 80 RPMs. So because we're slower, we want to add more resistance, right? No cue, no easy. We don't do that. Good. But if you are new on your fitness journey, I will say you don't want to go full throttle, right? I want you to enjoy this enough that you want to come back and do more. So if you kill yourself, you're going to be like, that sucked, I feel terrible, I don't want to do it again. That's not my goal, right? I'm doing these free classes because I love spin. I love being on the bike, I love vibing with music, I love vibing with riders. So, there's a reason for that. It feels good, and I believe that you can have a workout Connecting and committing to every side. don't make a habit of bailing before the song is over, unless you absolutely have to. Right. So now, this is your thickest. So, you're gonna find this on the left. Left. 54. Stand up. Reach up to third. And see. Good. So it's a smooth transition. Rise up. And if it felt like you went too fast, once you stand up, add some more. Good. Let's go back to first in the step. Reach out. Slow songs like the skinny hoe. Can't move all of this here to one of those. I'm a big stay up. Tempo. Good. Hold down. Hold. Yep. You're killing it. You're doing awesome. Turn up. Rise up. Go.
Fuck it up. Fuck it up.
Awesome. It is scientifically proven that either hearing or speaking swear words will make you work hard physically. Harder. Interesting, right? Have a seat. So just this transition in and out of the saddle, you're targeting different muscles in your body, right? So feeling ridiculously hard in the saddle. Good. We're going to stand up again. 4, 3, reach out. We're full.
Let's go.
Take a deep breath. Turn it up. It's getting really heavy here. Your biggest hill today. How's that feel? Do you know that self-esteem is essentially us doing something that is perceived as challenging or hard? So every one of these intervals is a little pebble in your self-esteem jar. Remember, every single one adds up. Right? It's like the tiny little things in your morning routine. You commit to doing your best. You commit to doing those things. Doesn't seem like a lot. It adds up at the end of the day. And really your goal? I want for you to be able to rest your head at night and be proud of yourself, right? So we're back at that 100 RPMs. So that's really what I'm constituting as more of a beginner pace. 110, 120, 128 is usually like your house mix. But don't ever feel pressured to be at that pace. It doesn't feel good for your knees, doesn't feel good for your body. You don't have to. You are the boss of you. You get to decide how this ride goes, and you get to decide what you think about that internal dialogue and how you feel when you're done. Right? It's pretty cool. Good. Add a little bit more right here. We took a whole lot off in that last song, so right now we're just feeling better. This is just about your breath. So take a deep breath in. Exhale out. Feel better. Good. 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2. So, dipping your toe in the water. We're going to do these faster jumps. 8 up, 8 down. 100 RPMs. Rise up. Yep, go on to second. Keep your hands flat. 4, 3, 2, 1. We made it to the last song already. Awesome. Okay, right here. Extend down, left foot down. Left, right. Increase your resistance right here. 62 RPMs is where you're at. Okay. Scoot your butt back. Lengthen through your spine. Two more things I want to mention to you. Make sure you're not hanging your head like this. So bad for your neck and shoulders. Keep yourself elevated and strong. And you're never resting your forearms. This is going to jack up the tiny muscles in your shoulders, your rotator cuff. So, use the strength in your abs. Use the strength in your upper body. We're putting pebbles in the jar. Come on. Hustle, hustle. All right, together. We rise. Let's go. Yeah. Show yourself what a badass you are. You got this. Four, three, back in the saddle. Hold your pace. Let's go. Good. So I'm singing pretty easily. I'm going to hold that and add a little bit more resistance. Need to be breathless right here. Three, two, one. Recover. Slow down your legs. Get your legs together. We got one more to go. So when you're ready, reconnect with that left, right. Good. So the one thing you'll notice as a beginner is that it takes a long time to recover. It takes a long time to feel better. So you'll also recognize when you get more fit, your recovery happens much faster. And that's a really cool thing, right? So just tune into that. Tune into how your body responds. We have a tendency to want to creep up like this. It's like I'm grinding up on the bars, right? Get your ass back. You know, I was talking about a higher spirit of glee. That happens when you push your butt back and you let your glutes do the work. Have a seat. 30 seconds. Ha. Yes, you can. Come on, we got the rest of the day to recover. The rest of the day to feel better. You're going to have all sorts of swagger when you get off this bike. 15. Come on. Don't forget to breathe. Focus right here. Can you add a little more? 7. 6. Ahead of the beat. 4. 3. 2. 1. You did it. So good. Alright, that felt awesome. Feel your resistance back. And just breathe. Just breathe. Your recovery, the biggest portion of that, you can control simply by focusing on taking deeper breaths. What we have a tendency to do, so your legs are just moving without any resistance on here right now. We have a tendency to freak out. And we start to breathe heavier. I mean, I've taught classes where like 10 minutes after class, I'll have a writer come up asking a question or something and they're still like panting. So, you have to remember, you are in control. You take slow, deep breaths and you never stop moving all of a sudden until your heart rate comes down, until you feel better. And then we can start to stretch. And if I'm moving into a stretch and you're not ready yet, pause the video. Do you cool down, feel better, and then start your stretch. So this is just a gentle, gentle press. Left arm extending towards the floor. Feels so nice. Even though we deliberately try not to acquire any tension in the shoulders, it just happens naturally. Just sitting at a desk or whatever we're doing all day, right? Good. Well, Roll your shoulders back, bring your chin to your chest. You can also do this. I find that my chest and my shoulders are always really tight. So just really focusing also on getting some stretches throughout the day just to keep your shoulder joints fluid and mobile, right? Go ahead and unclip your right foot. And at this point, I'm hopeful or assuming that you are okay with clipping in or out, or you've got cages. And if you do have cages, I would say that you will be best served getting some shoes that clip in. No joke, I don't make any money off of any of this. But you are going to pedal more efficiently. You're gonna get a better ride. Everything's gonna feel just more fluid and more natural. Ankle rotation both ways. And then come back in, we'll switch. But what I was trying to say is, as far as clipping in and clipping out, it's just a sweeping out of your heel and clipping in. You're just pointing in and down, making sure that the cleat catches onto your pedal. You can always extend your opposite arm up. But right now, just feeling gratitude for carving this time out for yourself, right? Feel better for the rest of the day. Get those in. My niece used to say dolphins. You'll get these dolphins swimming through your head. So I like to finish with a power pose. So you're stepping your feet a little bit wider than your hips. Think about your favorite superhero, how confident and strong and tall they stand. I want for you to emulate that and then realize that that is you. That is you. That is your strength. You have that strength inside of you. You have to open your eyes to it, acknowledge it, be aware of it. Marinate in it and spread it around. Show people you are confident, you are strong, you are an amazing human being. With gratitude, let's take a deep breath in, capture that beautiful energy, pull it to your heart, keep it with you, share it with others. Thank you so much. I hope to see you again tomorrow. Take care.